After graduation, Cooper plans to attend Columbia University to pursue his master's in public health and eventually apply to medical school. Everybody give one more hand for Cooper Moran. And last but certainly not least, from Staten Island, New York, a middle blocker number 23, Onika Onaga. Onika is joined by his family tonight. A three-year member of the team, Onika is most proud of being named Most Improved Player. He's collected 89 kills over 91 sets in his career with 57 total blocks. He had a career-high 7 kills in a win over Lehman this season. Onika is a member of the Pre-Law Society and plans to attend law school after graduation. Give another hand for Onika Onaga! Give it up one more time for your seniors. blocker, number 19, Kyle Barique Johnson. At middle blocker, number 20, Stephen Najazi. And at libero, number 4, Michael Rossman. The Bloodhounds are coached by Alex Bojic. And now, the starting lineup for your Hunter College Hawks. And outside hitter, a senior from Little Neck, number 9, Ted Kim. At center, a senior from Belmore, number 10, Cooper Moran. And outside hitter, a freshman from Santa Barbara, number 11, Kyle Foley. And in the blocker, a grad student from Queens, number 19, Anis Dojanin. And outside hitter, a sophomore from Beaver, number 22, John Fluger. And in the blocker, a senior from Staten Island, number 23, Onika Onaga. And at libero, a junior from New York, number 8, Nick Yao. The Hawks are coached by Chris Shorten, who is assisted by Blake Nixon and Mikey McCullough.
Sportsplex. All time has 63% winning percentage with UNIAC for winning percentage. He's Bojic was also Moran to Daljanin to get it going here on senior night as the Hawks strike first here at the Sportsplex. So here is one of the graduating seniors, Cooper Moran. The setter from Belmore is definitely going to be missed here at the Sportsplex as he just recently notched his 2,000th career assist for the Hawks. These starters out there for the Hawks. Nick Yao is in purple tonight. He's our libero for the evening. Ted Kim is out there. He's another senior who's graduating. He's an outside hitter, along with Cooper Moran. As we mentioned, Kyle Foley is in the back row right now, along with Anis Deljanin, the middle blocker, as Moran can't quite tip that towards a teammate. And John Pfluger, the sophomore from Pittsburgh, gets the nod, as well as his senior Onika Onaga. On John Jay's side of things, serving right now is Steven Ajazi for the Bloodhounds. He's out there with the libero, Michael Rossman, who is not on the floor right now. Kyle Barif Johnson is the one who just hit that a bit too far that time around, as now Rossman is in. Maxwell Law is number 6 on your screen. He's the setter for the side. Logan Ramos, number 12 on your screen. He's their outside hitter. And Jaden Lamar and Alex Bridgall are the other two starters for John Jay, as Kim gets an ace. Here is the senior from Little Neck, Ted Kim, who serves it up with such an instrumental team, excuse me, an instrumental part of the team last year, as he was a CUNYAC All-Star, but this season not playing up to par, started out the season injured, and he has been battling his way back through that. But yet the most important part of the season is still to come for the Hawks, where Kim can definitely play a crucial part of that. Bridgelaw for Barif Johnson, gets another touch to it, back to him, and that time Pfluger couldn't block it in. So as I mentioned at the top of this broadcast, last home game before playoffs start for the Hawks. After today, they're going to face off against Brooklyn on Tuesday night, and then they're going to travel to Poughkeepsie to face off against Springfield and Vassar in a tri-match that will hopefully gear them up for playoffs. Moran, backside Pfluger, the left-handed swing is good. It is a 5-3 game right now with the Hawks in the lead. As we're getting that scoreboard up for you at the moment. Del Janin up. Barif Johnson hits that out. Moran did not touch it. It's a Hawks point. So as you very clearly probably just saw, it is a 6-3 ball game. As Anis Del Janin, he's 10th in the league in aces this season, as he didn't get any against Baruch. Here's Barif Johnson again, trying to feed the big man, listed at 6'7 on the roster sheet. Pfluger a block that time. The libero moves to it. Rossman couldn't get a good enough feed for Barif Johnson, as it's a 7-3 game now. Some of the keys to the game tonight for the Hawks are going to be capitalizing on timeouts. Coming out of timeouts, CCNY and Baruch both went on huge runs against the Bloodhounds, so interrupting their momentum will be crucial for the Hawks. Bridgelaw decides to hit that time. It's a Hawks point. And another thing that the Hawks struggled with in their last game was passing. Cooper Moran had to work extra hard on Tuesday night against Baruch just to get to some of the passes from the back line. So if we can get our passes in order, our outsides will be much more thankful, as Del Janin saves that fully up, and Del Janin just has to send the free ball over. Not the cleanest of plays from the Hawks, but Pfluger is there once again. The 6'5 opposite side from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, has been huge for the Hawks tonight so far. Here's Anis Del Janin once again. Ramos handles that one. Bridgelaw outside. Barif Johnson tipped up. Seems like it hit the antenna. No, they're giving it on a double from the Hawks. So Deljanin is out now. Yao is back in the game. Here's Stephen Daly. Outside hitting senior from Staten Island. Went to Newdorp. Just barely squeaks that over the net. Back out for Foley. Gets that down the line. As that's another point for the Hawks. Here's Pfluger on the serve. Rossman handles it. Bridgelaw outside for Ramos. Who gets the kill? Ramos is going to be one to watch out for. He is fifth in the conference in points per set. And if you do it by total points, he's third, just behind the man who is on the bench right now, has not entered the game. That's Mohamed Mbaye, who's been struggling just a bit as of late. Moran to Onaga. Feeding the big man on senior night. Parents in attendance, whole family in attendance at that, looking to show out as they came all the way here from Staten Island. Here's Foley on the service. Daly to Bridgelaw outside. Ramos just taps it over. Aguado freshly subbed in. Here's Kim. Mishit that one just a bit. Ted Kim was a first-team All-Star last year, a transfer from Springfield, as that's a school that the Hawks will face very soon. Here's Kim again. Couldn't quite get it over the net. There was Bridgelaw. Kim gets blocked inside. Here's Alex Bridgelaw, the setter from Queens, is one of the best in Division III with serving the ball, but Aguado, no matter for him. Here's Foley. Gets it over the net, couldn't find the floor. Bridgelaw hitting now. Foley handles it. Aguado. Moran. Onaga! A good rally going from the Bloodhounds and Hawks, but Onaga is there for the block! And here is Onaga. He's known to be quite polite on the service. But the jump serve coming. Rossman handles it. Couldn't quite get the best pass off. Ramos gets blocked by Kim and Deljanin. Ramos again. That time he squeaks it past the pair. As Barif Johnson comes in for Daly. Barif Johnson, sixth in total blocks, standing in at 6'7". Here's Ramos, second in aces in the conference, behind his buddy Bridgelaw. Here's Kim. Kim with the kill. As Aguado will trade places with Pfluger. Aguado started the season in the libero position. He's the reigning libero of the year. But as of late, Nick Yao has been playing very well. So he's slotted into that setter position, or excuse me, libero position. In the last game against Baruch, Yao had a tough time in that back row. While he did have 13 digs in that game, all of his passes weren't up to par as Deljanin smacks it home. The last game that the Bloodhounds played was against CCNY. That was on Tuesday night while the Hawks were facing off against Baruch. CCNY did pull off a set from them, but John Jay finished the job at 3-1. As Kim serves that one just a bit too far. John Jay in that game against CCNY. 8 aces on the night compared to CCNY's 2. They're going to look to capitalize from behind the white line tonight. In that game, Logan Ramos led the team. He had 11 kills in 26 total attempts as Foley tries to touch it over. They're calling antenna on Foley, so it's going to be John Jay point. In the last game that these two teams played, Hunter ended up sweeping in 3 straight sets. But John Jay gave him a fight each set as Deljanin to Moran back out. Pfluger, the left hand, finds the seam. It was 25-21, 25-21 again, and then 25-23 in that last matchup. That was on the 2nd of March. As Deljanin serves it up, Bridge Law tried the setter dump, but the other setter, Moran, was there. Here's Foley, couldn't quite get a good angle on it. Bridge Law outside, Barif Johnson, who gets blocked. Onaga pleading for a tip, but no dice from the referee. Bridge Law will come out for Daly to serve now. Up and over. Kim gets a hand to it. Yao will set it up for Foley, who gets blocked. But it's out of bounds, so it is Hawks point. The Hawks have had success against John Jay in recent memory. Since 2012, they have not lost yet. Joust at the net, 50-50, won by the captain, Cooper Moran. Who else would it be? Here's Pfluger, it's a 17-13 ball game. Bridge Law outside for Ramos. Had a good game against the Hawks last time. Moran hustles over to it. Foley just has to tap it. Moran up. Yao this time. Back out. Foley finds the floor. Right in front of Sebastian Rodriguez. Excuse me, that was Daly. As it's a 5-point game at the moment. Timeout is needed. We'll be back in a minute 15. You're watching Hawk Athletics. Back here at the Sportsplex, Hawks up 18-13 at the moment. And as I mentioned before, in the keys to the game, Hawks might be able to capitalize coming out of timeouts as the Bloodhounds have been sloppy at that. And Hawks come out of the timeout on cue. It's 19-13 right now as the Hawks are going to look to pull away. The Bloodhounds are 6-2 in the last day games since they played against Hunter as Pfluger hits his buddy Onaga as they have a laugh. And Aguado will take Pfluger's place. In those eight games since the Bloodhounds have played Hunter, their two losses have come against the mighty Baruch. First game, Baruch swept the Bloodhounds. And in the second, they took a set as Foley smacks that one home. Put a bit of mustard on that one. I think that John Jay taking a set off Baruch right before they played Hunter was kind of a wake-up call for the Bearcats as they took care of business against the Hawks with ease, honestly. We just could not pass in that game. Baruch had 13 aces against us as Rossman sends the free ball. Moran thought about it. Onaga tips it over. And Ramos, Aguado, Moran, Onaga. Big rally coming up here. Aguado a tip to it. Moran outside. Kim has to readjust. Puts it in a good spot. Bridgelaw outside. Ramos. Onaga a tip to it. We're still going here. Foley coming in for the kill. Couldn't quite get it. Bridgelaw outside. Ramos blocked again. And finally, the point goes to the Bloodhounds. A long rally that John Jay eventually won. Well, there you go. So let's keep talking about that Hunter and Baruch game on Tuesday night. 25-21 in the first set, 25-22 in the second as Onaga slams that one home for the kill, and 25-15 in the third set. The Hawks in the first set did pretty well for themselves. They hit 357 in the first set. But the big kicker was the runs that Baruch went on. When the score was 4-2 in the first set, as Ajazi gets the kill, they're saying on a tip, as Rossman and Barif Johnson trade places. From the 4-2 mark, Baruch went 5 points on, excuse me, 6 points unanswered, which cannot happen against the best team in Cuniac right now if you want to win the game. And additionally, Baruch went on another 5-point run later in the set to go from 15-all to 19-15. They found themselves down two for the rest of the set and couldn't quite mount the comeback to win the first. In the second set, it was 11-12 with Baruch up, and then both teams went on consecutive 4-point runs. By that point, it was 20-21, and Baruch just powered through the Hawks as Moran sets it up. Barif Johnson on the other side rose to it, but Pfluger and Deljanin were there. Pfluger a tip to it. Yao back out for Pfluger, left-handed, gets it down the seam for the kill. So it's 23-16 at the moment. Hawks looking to take this first set as timeout is needed. We'll be back in a minute 15. You're watching Hawk Athletics. back here at the Sportsplex. Cooper Moran to get us going here out of the timeout. It's 23-16 right now. Hawks looking to take the first set home as Bridgelaw helps to the Hawks' case. So set point here. We were talking about Baruch before the timeout, and runs were the huge part of that game. As Moran out, Barif Johnson gets blocked. Deljanin and Pfluger once again there. The 6-7 and 6-5 buddies get it done to seal the first set for the Hawks, 25-16. We'll be back in about 3 minutes for the second set. Hawks up 1-0. You're watching Hawk Athletics. Hello and welcome back to the Sportsplex. Hawks took the first one 25-16 as they're looking to bounce back in this second set. And a straight sweep of John Jay would be perfect in the Hawks' mind. Kind of clean up their sloppy play as of late. Let's talk about Austin Voges real quick, a former Hunter coach. He won us our last two CUNYAC championships, as now Chris Shorjan is looking to lead the Hawks to the first, to his first championship with this team, and especially for these seniors. Cooper Moran, one of those seniors, has been to the championship game every year that he's been here, but has not been able to bring it home. The championship game this year is going to be played at Arc Arena. So if Baruch, who are likely candidates to get there, as John Jay get the first point. If Hunter can get to that championship game, Baruch are likely opponents. And they would have another chance. Bridge Law. Can't quite get it over the net. One of the best serves in all of CUNYAC. 55 aces on the year compared to 58 errors coming into the match. Impressive from the setter. Here's our number 9, Ted Kim. The senior in his last home regular season game. Looking to help the Hawks. Here's Pfluger, who put a bit too much on that one. As it's 1-2 now, John Jay in the lead. When Austin Voges was the head coach here at Hunter in 2017, as Kim passes to Moran. Moran outside to Foley, and that is a recipe for disaster. In 2017, our tournament MVP was Steven Tarquino. He had 14 kills and 5 assists in the win and was also the tournament MVP. That was the last time that we made it. We had a win in the NCAA championship, as that's a go for Steven Ajazi to make it 3-2, John Jay. In that win that we had, it was over the number 9 ranked volleyball team, Penn State Altoona, where we swept in 3 straight sets. So very impressive from the Hawks. And that was our last win, as Moran outside to Onaga. He's been having a monster game tonight on senior night. And then after that, well, the Hawks were faced with a tough matchup in the number 1 ranked Springfield College. We lost that one in 3 straight sets, however. And then in the next year, when we won the championship once again, Blake Hogan was our MVP. Voges once again with another championship, as Pfluger gets the ace for the Hawks. In our NCAA appearance that time, we lost to Dominican University in 3 straight sets. Here's Pfluger for another ace. That's his 10th ace on the season. He's in double digits now for the Hawks. So as the standings are at the moment, the Hawks are in the 2 spot, where they are likely to stay after they lost both games against Baruch. As Aguado will come in for Pfluger. So the number 1 seeded Baruch will face the winners of the 4 and 5 seeds, which at the moment are Brooklyn and Lehman. And then John Jay would face off against CCNY, who's in the 6 seed. As Foley can't tip it over the net, it's a tie game at 5-5. And then Hunter would face the winner of John Jay and CCNY. Up and over from Maxwell Law, as Onaga with the hang time. Aguado, Moran, feed him again. Onaga again, as that's too many. As it looks like they're giving the point on a double? I'm not quite sure what the call was there from the official in the high chair. A yellow card, I believe, is being shown. The ball is nowhere to be found. I don't know if we're waiting to reset or what's going on. It seems like Austin Voges was the recipient of the yellow card. As we're going to get going now. Maxwell Law, the setter from Elmhurst, will resume play. It's 5-5 here at the Sportsplex. The Hawks not playing their best volleyball coming into this second set. And we will finally, seems like we'll resume. Here's Law. Yao mishandles it. Moran has to hustle over. Right side, Foley gets the kill. Ramos in the back row wasn't able to handle that. As it's 6-5 Hawks. Here's Foley, up and over. Not his best performance against Baruch as that hits the antenna. It's Hawks point. Foley against Baruch led the team in kills along with Muhammad Mbay. They both had 9 each. But Foley and Mbay sloppy on the total hitting percentage. Foley hit 300 with one of those in the Baruch game and now has one here tonight. As Mbay hit 182 against Baruch with the most attempts on the team with 22. And also worth noting, Matisse Lee Marek, the reigning player of the year, is not in attendance tonight, working through some personal issues at the moment. But the Hawks have been missing him. Very much so. Especially against Baruch. Onaga up and a bit too far over. Snuck over the net as Moran sets it outside for Kim. As that's going to be a confidence booster from the outside from Little Neck. Kim on the season, just 46 kills coming into today. It's a 9-7 ball game as our 10 gives John Jay their 8th. Moran with the error that time was a CUNYAC first team All-Star last season, and he just recently won Player of the Week, which he deservedly won after a sensational week. Kim once again putting that extra power behind that one. It looks like he's gotten some confidence back. Right now, John Jay is 15-6 overall, boosting a great record as they're 8-4 in the conference. Ramos gets it down the seam. Last year, John Jay, 18-10 overall, and 9-4 in CUNYAC. As they look like they might end up with a similar record this year. They face off against York for their final CUNYAC matchup of the season as Deljanin spikes it home. The passing has been much better tonight from the Hawks, something that they struggled so heavily with against the Bearcats on Tuesday night, making sure to do a better job of it here as Deljanin It's Foley in the head that time. It's 11-10. John Jay had been right here this entire second set as Jaden Lamar comes back in for John Jay. Ajazi up and over. Moran, backside. Pfluger gets blocked up there. That's Barif Johnson. It's 11-all. As the Bloodhounds are wishing for something special here in this second set. They know they're capable. They've taken one from Baruch. The confidence rising. Kim mishandles. Yao calls it. Foley outside that time finds the floor. A big retaliation from Foley. In that game against Baruch that the Bloodhounds had, they took the second set from them where they hit 4-12 in the second set with 17 total kills. In the first set, they had negative 38.5 hitting percentage. So this John Jay team is known to be able to turn things around quickly as they're looking to do against the Hawks here. And in that game against Baruch, Kyle Barif Johnson, 19 total kills for him as Ramos also had 11 kills and 19 assists to go along with 9 digs. Almost a triple-double. As that's 4 touches, it's Hawks point. Here's John Pfluger. Has been struggling a little bit from behind the service line. The lefty sends that one over, though. Ramos handles it well. Barif Johnson gets blocked. Onaga with the head tap. The bench is ecstatic. The Hawks have some momentum. It's 15-11 right now. Pfluger up. Not over, though. Aguado back in. If you're looking to tune into some more Hawks action, the men's tennis team is playing Baruch tomorrow at 12 p.m. That's going to be in Flushing, so make sure to tune into that one. In addition, Aguado can't get there on that one. In addition, the softball team is going to have their first home game tomorrow afternoon against Mount St. Vincent at 3 p.m. and 5 p.m. That's going to be at Randall's Island. So make sure to tune into that one. I won't be on the call for that one. Kennedy Dury from the women's basketball team will be on the call of that one as Kim comes in for the kill. ...16-13 at the moment. John Jay has been known to stay with the pack. They've kept it close in their previous game against the Hawks, getting in the 20s in each set. Didn't do that in the first set. Edge Bridgelaw gets blocked by Onaga and Moran. Moran has actually snuck into the top 10 in blocks in the conference from the setter position. He's fifth right now in total blocks and ninth in blocks per set. Ramos. Free ball coming over from Rossman. Foley. Moran outside. Onaga touches it home. Rushes right over to his fellow senior Cooper Moran. We're going to miss that connection here at the Sportsplex. No doubt about that. as that's a bit too far from Foley. Foley struggled on service. In the pass game, an error for him. 18-14, 4-point game as Daly up and over. Aguado handles it. Good pass to Moran. Onaga blocked up front. Moran up for Yao. Yao pushing it. Moran gonna hit this time and gets the kill. He gives a thumbs up to his family. A great moment for Cooper Moran. The reigning player of the week, I might add. Here's Onaga, gets it over Rossman. Over, here's Bridgelaw, blocked up front. But it sneaks behind for a John Jay point. They're still right there, they're within four right now. Here's Jaden Lamar, fully handles Moran outside. Kim soaring through the air, couldn't find the floor though. Ramos just touches it over. Aguado, a great dig out. Here's Foley, back row swing for the kill. 2015, what a time. Timeout is needed. No, excuse me, no timeout. Yes, timeout, Jesus. All right, we'll be back in a minute 15. You're watching Hawk Athletics. Back at the Sportsplex, Moran gets it going here. Outside, Bridgelaw way too far on that one. As it seems like the official wants to talk over possible tip at the net. John Jay fighting for the point. They're going to give it to the Hawks, though. Hawks not the best serving team, fourth in the conference, while they're facing off against John Jay, who's the best from behind the service line. But Kim says, oh, hit it right down that service line. It's 22-15. Moran. Ramos handles it. Rossman has to hustle over. Free ball coming over. Let's see what the Hawks can conduct. Pfluger can't quite get the kill. Bridgelaw, another free ball. Hawks with another chance to run a set play. Foley coming in for the kill. No good. John Jay playing great defense. Bridgelaw. Kim with the block. Rossman outside. Ramos blocked again. Pfluger sends that one over. Bridgelaw, the left-hander, blocked again. Ramos, blocked again. Deljanin! On his ads one for the Hawks, it's 23-15. Another timeout is needed by Austin Voges. We'll be back in just a minute. Hawks up 23-15. You're watching Hawk Athletics. Back here at the Sportsplex as Pfluger sets us off. It's 24-16 right now. 15. As the Hawks have set point once again. The first set was 25-16. As Moran wants to finish it with an ace. A little bit more muster there. Couldn't quite get it there. Oh, almost got it, but free ball coming over. Moran, Deljanin finishes it off for the Hawks. 25-15 is the final score in the second set. We'll be back in 3 minutes for the third. You're watching Hawk Athletics. back here at the Sportsplex as we're getting going. Here for the third set, Moran gets it going. He's going to miss doing that for the Hawks. As Hawks jump out to an early 1-0 lead. Outside, Bridgelaw blocked up front. The tall Fluger and Deljan in there once again. Moran puts it way up. As that's going to be Hawks' point on, I believe, a rotational issue. Deljanin gets the, oh, Ramos, a sensational save. Moran outside, Kim blocked up front. As John Jay is hype. They're looking to come back against the Hawks. They're down two sets already. As here's Daly once again. Kim, a good dig out. Here's Fluger, the left-hander, gets the kill. Here's Ted Kim, the senior from Little Neck. A two-time All-Star for the Hawks. Gets it going, puts a lot on that one, and gets it in for the ace. As the We Love Ted chants are reigning in. And here he is. That time couldn't quite get it down the line. Here's Steven Ajazi. The middle-blocking sophomore gets it going. Kim passes it up. Moran gets a hand to it. Fluger just has to send it over. John Jay has a chance to retaliate. Ramos. Yao outside now. Foley wound that one up and got the kill. So the Hawks right now are playing without basically two of their best players, that being Matisse Lee Marek, who is not in attendance today, and Muhammad Mbaye, who has not made an appearance yet in the game. Deljanin up and over. Outside, Ramos to hit. Deljanin in the back row that time. Got a hand to it as Onaga will send the free. Outside, Bridgelaw. Fluger. Moran. Kim gets blocked. Here's Bridgelaw, one of the best serves in the country, but no problem for Kim. Fluger, a bit too far. Hawks up 6-3 at the moment. Here's Fluger, who's been getting more minutes towards the end of the season this year. He's going to be a crucial part of this team, especially with that left-hand swing. Just couldn't quite get it inbounds that time. As he's going to sub out for Aguado. As that's in, Ramos with an ace, his first tonight. Here's Ramos once again, 6-5. John Jay in the lead. Aguado wanted it, but Moran called him off. Foley blocked up front. It's a 6-6 game. John Jay does not go away. That's been a theme for quite some time. The Bloodhounds have some fight in them. Ramos. Aguado handles it. Here's Foley who finds the floor that time. Foley already with double-digit kills for the Hawks. Bit too far from Foley again. Hawks have been working on their serving all season. That was one of the things that they struggled with the most early in the season and in the first couple home games here at the Sportsplex. Just couldn't quite get their stuff inside. Moran gets it in. What a smart play from Cooper Moran. A back row set, quote unquote. No, he's just finding the floor. Moran, after he graduates, is going to attend Columbia to pursue a master in public health, and then he's eventually going to med school. So we know he's on a great track, as his brother Hunter was as well. Kim has to just reset. Bridgelaw, Ramos gets the kill. It's 8-all. John Jay has not had the lead here in this third set, but they have come awfully close a couple times. Mental toughness is something that the Hawks have seemed to have struggled with, playing down to some of their opponents and not playing up when they've needed to. Deljanin gets the kill. The Hawks, after their first time playing Baruch, had a bit of a lull in their schedule. Medgar Evers twice, CCNY, York, and Lehman, all games that they should have swept in three straight sets and did exactly that, but not with their most pristine volleyball. Hence why that Baruch game was so tough on Tuesday night. Daly hitting that time, couldn't get it. Kim touches it over. Rossman hustles over to get it. Backside Pfluger. Outside Bridgelaw a bit behind him. Yao has to come in for it. Moran, a no-look center dump from the captain. He's so fantastic at doing that. In the beginning of the season, he did it quite a number of times. And then, honestly, he just stopped for a little bit. No explanation for it, but just wasn't working, so he didn't do it. But now he's back to his ways as he sets that up for Kim, who almost gets the kill. Rossman has free ball coming over. Deljanin gets the kill. Deljanin is, his presence is definitely felt for the Hawks, especially in the absence of Matisse Lee Marek. He's been hitting one of the best percentages in all of CUNYAC this season, as he is third in the conference, hitting 314. And who he's behind? as he gets the kill that time. He's behind Kai Barif Johnson. Kyle Barif Johnson on John Jay, and of course Matisse Lee Marek, his teammate who's in first. Moran up and over. Try to put a bit too much on that one. Hawks want to pull away if they can. A couple points in a row will be crucial, especially starting with a service error. Here's Kim, up but can't quite sneak it over the net. Kim last year led the team in kills, 228. And after that, Andrew Estevern, 135, who has not made too many appearances so far this season. As this Hunter team has had a couple new faces come in and just a change of style. Anis Eljanin, one of those people that came in for the Hawks and immediately got into the starting lineup and made an impact right away. The 6-7 frame does help, I do have to say. Ramos touches it up. Foley, a diving save. Pfluger jumps to it. Free ball coming over. Ramos couldn't quite get the angle right. Smacked up from Eljanin. Outside, Ramos gets blocked. Onaga, who else? Soak it all in, Onika Onaga. As timeout is needed. We'll be back in a minute 15. You're watching Hawk Athletics.
What
back here at the Sportsplex. Hawks up 16-10 at the moment, winning the first set 25-16 and the second set 25-15. As they're looking to finish it up, as Eljanin with a good serve. Bloodhounds a miscommunication as Onaga gets blocked up front. He wanted that one, but no dice that time. 16-11. We're winding down on this men's volleyball season. The final will be played on April 12th at Baruch College. Onaga tips it up, and it'll be interesting to see what happens this year. In recent years, Baruch have dominated. And right before that, Hunter dominated. And then before that, Baruch dominated. So we've been going back and forth. The last time that we had a non-Lexington Lexington located school in the championship game was in 2002, where Lehman College faced off against York. Excuse me, Lehman and CCNY, and Lehman won that one. So those two have been dominating the CUNYAC since 02. And for reference, that's when the seniors were born. Up and over from Pfluger, Rossman handles though. Bridgelaw outside, Ramos on the slide run. Pfluger smartly lets it go. It's 19-11. Pfluger focusing here as he lets a good one loose. Barif Johnson has to relocate to it. Foley smacks it home though. As timeout is needed once again. It's 20-11. We'll be back in a minute. You're watching Hawk Athletics. Back here at the Sportsplex, John Pfluger will be the one to start it off. Hawks up 20-11 here. Have been dominating thus far against the Bloodhounds and looking to continue that and continue momentum going into the rest of the week. Great dig out from Nick Yao. But fully the error that time. As it's 20-12. Aguado comes in for Pfluger. As I mentioned before, next up on the Hawks schedule, they're going to finish out the CUNYAC season against Brooklyn College. That's going to be in Brooklyn on Tuesday night, as Foley can't quite get to that. And then after that, the Hawks are going to travel to Poughkeepsie to face off against Springfield and Vassar to hopefully up their play going into the CUNYAC playoffs. Their first game is likely to be on April 12th, and I'm sure of that if they win this game, as they have the tiebreaker over John Jay, of course. So they're gonna wait to see who they will play. It'll likely be John Jay and CCNY, whoever wins that game. As it's 21-14 right now. Checking in is Evan Wandersee. First time entering the game today. Yao digs it out. Moran outside. Kim with the exclamation point. The seniors have been performing tonight for sure, as Lucas George will check in for one of those seniors whose night may be done tonight. His last regular season CUNYAC game for Onika Onaga, who gets high fives around from the bench. He played a great game tonight as George gets it going. He was big in the Baruch game the other night in that middle blocker position as that hits the antenna. It's Hawks point, 23-14. George up and over. Bridge Law for Ramos, who has to readjust. Who's there? Deljanin, of course. 24-14. The Hawks have been consistent here tonight. John Jay has been averaging about 15 points per set. Right now they got 14. George with match point. Seals it with the ace. 25-14 in the final set. The Hawks grab the win against the Bloodhounds. 25-16 in the first, 25-15 in the second, and 25-14 in the third and final set. The Hawks did a good job of bouncing back after their horrendous game the other night against Baruch, where they were swept in three straight sets. So a big game for the Hawks as they're looking to continue their momentum going into next week, as they're going to face off against Brooklyn College on Tuesday, Springfield and Vassar over the weekend in Poughkeepsie, and then it'll be time for playoffs. They're going to wait the winners of likely John Jay and CCNY. So although this John Jay side is upset with the outcome today, they might have a chance for revenge coming up. Next up for the Bloodhounds, however, before that CUNYAC matchup, is going to be a Tuesday night matchup at the Doghouse against York College. As we're going to get you some stats from tonight's game, leading the Hawks was Kyle Foley. He's been sensational against John Jay this year. 11 kills for him on his Deljanin, followed it up with 8 of his own. Seniors Ted Kim and Onika Onaga with 6 and 4 kills each. Cooper Moran, the other senior tonight, 25 assists from him with 5 digs to go along with that. On the other side of things, leading for John Jay was Logan Ramos. He had 6 kills tonight, while Kyle Barif Johnson was held to just 4. Overall, the Hawks hit pretty well for themselves. 308, 458, and 375 across the three sets, while John Jay was held in the negatives throughout. So that'll just about do it here at from the Sportsplex. Tomorrow, make sure to tune into the softball game. That's at 3 and 5. That's a home game against Mount St. Vincent at Randall's Island. For David Horn and the rest of the Hawk Athletics crew, saying goodbye, and we'll see you